Good evening, everyone. I'm sure quarantine is making everybody stressful, frustrating, sometimes boring. So the idea is that, you know, we should call this an informative session so that people can learn something out of it. And also, this is the first series of Roundtable. So welcome to the first, we're calling it the Experts Roundtable. We come and do this every week once. Let me start with my good friend Devita, because ladies. So Devita Saraf is the founder and CEO of View Technologies, one of the prime most company which has been doing television, and I've known her since the time I started my company, so I can call her a friend. Then we have Mr. Tarun Garg, who is the director of sales, marketing and service with Hyundai Motor. Then we have Mr. Dinesh Galeria. He is also director of sales, marketing and service with Honda Two Wheelers. So we try to match the same designation between Mr. Tarun and Dinesh. And then of course we have Mr. Madhav Seth. He is the CEO of Realme, one of the most disruptive smartphone brands in the country. Will you go back to on-ground launches or you continue with web-based launches?
I think this lockdown has given us a new mantra for doing our online launches. I think that is mainly because of the social distancing, but I still believe that basically on-ground launches gives us a connect point with media friends like you and also with our core fans, where we get on ground real feedback on what the product is all about and how do they like the product or what are the shortcomings of the product. So I think that's really important, but I think this is a new mantra of the new age that basically we are trying to do online video launches and still keep the rhythm going on.
Yeah, then the two-wheeler showrooms typically have the highest footfall. What are the changes are you planning once the lockdown ends in terms of sanitization, social distancing in your showrooms?
Of course, there is going to be a big change because typically in the auto business, it is less of online. Online may be the awareness part, the tracking of the models, knowing more specifics of the product. But the real experience starts at the showroom once they walk in, touch and feel of the product. That's what differentiates the auto buying. That so far India didn't go so much on online.
So Tarun, what do you think once the lockdown is over, what is going to be the new normal according to you, you know, in terms of
Yes, I think this is what everybody is wondering, what's going to be the new normal. I believe new shifts will emerge in attitudes, policy, work, consumption. I believe compliance will be the new normal, civic sense will be the new normal, family time will be the new normal. I think all of us have learned a lot of new things.
What was the first thought which came to your mind when you heard the word lockdown? Did you cancel
your Well, I was kind of prepared for it because my classmates from Harvard Business School across the world were on a chat and every country was going through these situations. So they actually had a lot of notes prepared on how to work from home. So a week before the lockdown actually happened, I called for a management meeting and asked every person from every team that in case of a lockdown, what is the contingency plan for the next 1 week, 1 month, you know, to ensure that your entire department is connected remotely? Do we have a tech per person?
Some talk about an app like WeChat, which is almost every Chinese uses it. And you know, it's green, blue, black, the way China is managing. You think something like this would be close to hot bundle, or you think that's not going to happen?
I would say that basically we haven't received any request yet for the force bundle, but I think the awareness for the Aarogya Setu app right now is one of the highest thing, and people would already have it on their devices right now. Over a period of time, yes, this can be more useful, and you know, we can increase the scope of awareness to other, not only to C19, but other facts of the society also. But I think this can be really helpful.
Now, you know, the crude price has come down to zero levels, and you're being paid to the crude. How does it affect electric cars? Because in electric cars, primary motive is that, you know, you save on fuel, must number one. Of course, you save the world climate. And then, you know, in the lockdown, people have again realized that electric is good because you don't have to go to the petrol pump, but you can actually charge your car and just drive it out. So you think this petrol price, if it continues to go down, will that affect the electric car consumption?
Look, Ramesh, I think when we just the advent or the progress of electric cars, if we try to just link it to their fuel prices, I think it's a very myopic view of things. I believe electric vehicles are much more than just a comparison of the cost of ownership.
So you think that post lockdown we'll have a controlled demand, because now people are going to spend more time on things and less fire to you. You already talking about.
You have no idea how many people have just called me and being like, we urgently need one more TV, or we need a TV. I'm like, I don't have stock in my house. I'm sorry.
No TVs in the house. So do you think Honda now will ramp up the online booking, or you're looking at really wait to make people, as you just discussed, you're already looking at ramping up now? In your audio.
Yes. Yeah. So now the point is that we are all talking about a moving target, and definitely we cannot hit a moving target with fixed mindset or fixed strategies in hand. So what Devita has just mentioned, that we are reading a lot, and this is the right time when lot many people are hungry for some information, and analysts are playing with that mindset and providing you many new things to read every day. So you cannot make and change your strategies based on what you are reading. So I think we need to, of course, it's a lockdown time, but it is not look down time. Right? So we cannot go outside, but we can always go inside and reinvent, reimagine.
Post-COVID, our productivity levels have gone up or gone down. Do you think work from home, 3 days working, 3 days working from home, or something, it will become a normal, like people will be very comfortable giving people work from home, like for employees,
I would say that it again depends upon, you are in which vertical and your area of work. Naturally, production cannot happen. If I'm in production, I'm in manufacturing, I need to go. I have to be physically present on the manufacturing line. But having said that, I'm sure now those traditional industries or traditional mindset that we also have over the years evolved, we have also grown through the ranks and we have got set mind.
Work from home will be useful in emergency situations also. So, if an employee can't come in on a particular day, or there's a shut, there's bad weather, there's like some, bund or something, people will expect people to work from home. I think people can
What is the biggest challenge you find working from home?
I would say planning and planning, no actions. So I think that's the biggest thing which
giving a pat on the shoulder to the employee. And plus, I will just tell you, in addition to what Mr. Guleria said and Madhav said, basically we're all very, very result oriented people. The entire team, especially the marketing and sales part of it, adrenaline rush is there. Okay, today this many sales achieved, how much is to be done. Now, when you see all these things happening, you will say, okay, patient, the operation is successful, but the patient is dead. The whole day we are making strategies, and we think that they're great strategies, but how do I measure the results? And like Devita said, the lockdown, okay, we're all waiting, 20th something will happen, we were all ready, now we are waiting for third, then maybe. So there is a lot of, I think, inefficiency also coming into the system, because the plans are being made, remade. So we will actually see the effect.
Tell me one book or show you picked up which is really you've been able to read that book, which you would like to tell all our attendees. Adam, you done?
Many books.
Book. We are on lockdown.
There are many books. Yeah. There are many books I love to read. So there's a book which I'm reading from J.W. Collins. I think it's From Good to Great. So that is what I'm trying to do it. And
I think I've been spending a lot of time digitally on, Instagram, or even seeing how TikTok works, because, the customers today, the ones who are driving the business, the millennial buyers, have a whole different taste, and they consume content so differently than ours, and they have big pockets to buy all of our products.
First time, after 5 years, they have come back home. They're sitting at Amazon. And so I think last 1 month, it has been great knowing about them and how they have changed. And so we talk about customers, like Devita said. We all talk about millennials, and we believe that we know them. We want to believe that. But I mean, this last 30 days has been a great learning for me as a marketer, as a father, as a human being. How things are changing, and believe you me, this COVID is also changing the millennials big time. And I don't know how we are going to leverage this, because suddenly I hear sounds like saving from them. So I don't know, you know, because last 4-5 years we were all thinking that all our strategies have to be, keeping in mind these people. But this is the first time these people are subject to this kind of an environment where they are restricted.
A lot of people have been asking this question, and of course we also discuss the same thing. There's a clear writing on the wall that post lockdown, people who have been using shared economy, like Ola's and Uber's, they've been suffocated because they couldn't travel, right? Do you think there will be a big spike in sales? Because when that happens, it will be the most benefited will be Hyundai and more competition, of course. But do you think that people, there will be a big surge in car buying because of sanity?
Look, if we look at the China example, I think there is enough evidence to suggest that, yes, people will look for safer mobility. And I would put it as smart mobility, and Hyundai has been a pioneer in smart mobility. Our subscription model, which we launched last year, I think probably is going to take some more traction, especially on personal mobility, whether it's entry level, whether it is SUVs, whether it is sedans. I think a good advantage which we have as Hyundai is that we have a complete range.
All right, everybody can take a picture. So we'll have to do something else, but anyway, I'll be like this. Guys, 1, 2, 3. There we go. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
It was such a nice and eye-opening setup. Very, very diverse discussion. Keep doing it. Thank you once again. Thank you so much. Have a good weekend ahead now. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye, Madhav.
Bye, everybody. Thank you.